I'm Sara Eshke. I am a site engineer in Copthall Tunnel, located between West Ruislip Portal and Colne Valley Viaduct on HS2 project. Copthall Green Tunnel is an 880 metre structure. It's divided into three main sections. So we have base slab, we have walls, and then the roof soffit. What you see behind me is the breach deck. It's going to be part of Harvey Road realignment. The very first stage is excavation. From where I'm standing right now, 1.5 metre deeper, we've done the excavation. Once the excavation is completed, we do piling. So we have done piling in the western portal where I'm standing right now. After the piling has been completed, then we do RC works, it's called reinforcement. So we build a cage, reinforced cage, and once the reinforced cage is completed, we do shuttering. Shuttering is basically building a box or a mold. So once we pour the concrete into that cage, it keeps the shape of the base slab. Once the concreting stage has finished, each concreting stage is about 440 or 50 average meter cube. That's about 67 lorries, 40 lorries, depending on the element that we are pouring on the day. Once the concrete has been poured and cured, then we move on to the next structure. Again, we start with the reinforced work, reinforced rebar that you see behind me. And then again, a lot of quality checks to ensure everything is completed or is built to the design and to the standards, and then we concrete again and so on.
Yeah, my name is Raymond Maloney. I'm the senior project manager here at Copthall Green Tunnel. So progress to date, obviously, as you can see behind us, we've practical completion on the western portal section, which is 110 metres long. The roofs, the wall sections are completed up to 300 metres now, and we're at the moment working on the first 100 metres of the roof section, which we're forecasting for completion by the end of June this year. On site as it stands today, we've commenced the erection of the roof traveller, which we will use to complete the last 450 linear metres of the tunnel section. It consists of a 40 metre long deck, which is basically put in place to tie the reinforcement. There's a support carriage goes up underneath it. It supports it during the pour until it can be struck. At that point, it retracts, it moves 20 metres forward to the east, it opens back out, goes and commences steel installation on the next section of roof at that point. So the wall traveller on site has allowed us to reduce cycle times from 16 days to 9 days. It allows us to turn this into a line that we actually were able to progress steel fixing ahead of it. We move the wall traveller forward, we close it in 1 day, we pour it, cure it for 3 or 4 days, move it forward again. It's completely operated by hydraulics, and it effectively picks the shutters up off the ground, lifts them up in a big wide gantry, walks them forward by 20 metres, closes them, and then we rinse and repeat as we move through the tunnel, heading closer to West Ruislip.
So over the 2 years lifespan of the project, we are going to excavate about 1.1 million cubes of material. And that all of that material is going to be put back on top of the tunnel. And that's one of the reasons why the entire tunnel was redesigned. It's a greener method of construction, so we have saved millions of lorry movements.